86. The Guru's Thief. The master's task is not only to teach, but to help the disciple in overcoming his difficulties. He alone is a true friend who not only advises us regarding what to do in difficulties, but also helps us in freeing ourselves from them. Philosophy of the Masters. Bhai Gurdas was the uncle of Guru Arjan Dev, and at the same time, his devoted disciple and a highly spiritual person. At one time, he composed the following lines and read them to the Guru. If a mother is impious, it is not for her son to punish her. If a cow swallows a diamond, her stomach should not be cut open. If a husband is unfaithful, his wife should remain chaste. If a king issues leather money, his subjects should not worry. If the guru tests a disciple, the disciple's faith should not waver. He was trying to persuade the disciples that their faith should remain unshaken in all circumstances. Guru Arjan listened attentively as Bhai Gurdas read. All these things are easier said than done, Guru Arjan thought to himself. Let me test his faith, for I detect a touch of ego. Uncle, he said to Bhai Gurdas, I have to buy some horses in Kabul. Will you be able to do this for me? Why not? Certainly I will, Bhai Gurdas replied. At that time, there was no paper or small silver money. Only gold sovereigns were legal tender. Accordingly, Guru Arjan filled several bags with sovereigns. Bhai Gurdas counted them and then sealed the bags and put them in strong wooden boxes. These were loaded on mules, and Bhai Gurdas, with a number of other disciples, started out on the long and arduous journey to Kabul from Lahore, where Guru Arjan was then residing. Bhai Gurdas was a very learned scholar and quite familiar with the scriptures, and because of this, he gave religious discourses in many of the villages through which their caravan passed. In due time, after passing through the awe-inspiring gorges of the Khyber Pass, they reached Kabul, high amidst the snow-capped mountains of the Hindu Kush, and pitched their tents on the outskirts of the city. In the great horse market of this ancient city, Bhai Gurdas bargained with the Pathan horse traders and finally purchased the best animals he could find. He handed them over to a group of the disciples who were to take the horses, by easy stages, to Guru Arjan at Lahore. Meanwhile, Bhai Gurdas asked the Pathan merchants to come to his tent to be paid. Leaving the dealers outside, Bhai Gurdas entered the tent to get the needed number of bags filled with gold sovereigns. Opening a few of the boxes, he took out the needed bags. But something was wrong. Filled with foreboding, he opened all the bags. Each and every one of them was filled with pebbles and stones instead of gold. Bhai Gurdas was beside himself with horror, for he knew the savage nature of the Pathans. There they are, waiting for me outside the tent, and I have nothing with which to pay them, he thought. And if I don't pay them, they will tear me to pieces. His brain worked like lightning as he tried to devise a plan to save himself. So great was his fright that he even forgot to ask his Satguru for help. He tore a hole in the back of the tent and ran away as fast as he could, evading capture by the Pathans. Ashamed to face Guru Arjan, he passed quickly through Lahore, left Amritsar behind, and made his way to Kashi, hundreds of miles to the east. Back in Kabul, his fellow disciples had entered his tent to discover why he delayed paying the Pathan horse dealers. They found all of the wooden boxes open and filled with gold, but there was not a sign of Bhai Gurdas. However, they did notice the hole in the back of the tent. To stop the clamoring of the Pathans, the disciples paid them and then made their way back to Lahore, where they told Guru Arjan all that had happened. Now, a holy person like Bhai Gurdas, no matter where he may be, will always be interested only in spiritual matters and in giving spiritual discourses. So when Bhai Gurdas had settled down in Kashi, he began to give spiritual discourses, and people began to treat him like a great saint. Hundreds and then thousands of people came to hear him, and in the end the governor of Kashi also came to admire Bhai Gurdas's brilliant discourses. A few months later, when Guru Arjan heard of Bhai Gurdas's whereabouts, he sent a letter to the governor of Kashi. "A thief from our area is in Kashi, and I am writing to ask you kindly to take him prisoner, to tie his hands and send him to me," wrote Guru Arjan. "You will not have to search hard for this thief. The mere reading of this letter in places of public assembly and religious discourses will find him, for the thief himself will speak out when he hears the letter read." In due course, the letter was read where Bhai Gurdas was giving a discourse to a very large crowd of people. "I am the guru's thief," said Bhai Gurdas the moment he heard what was in the letter. His audience was stunned. "You could never be a thief, for you are a holy man," they said. "The thief must be someone else." "I am definitely the thief," he told them again. "There is no doubt of it. Please tie my hands so that I do not escape." No one came forward to do so, for it was unthinkable to tie up a holy man as if he were a common robber. Accordingly, Bhai Gurdas took off his turban, cut it in two, and tied his own hands as best he could. In this condition, he set out for Amritsar and Lahore to find his beloved Satguru. Driven by his intense love, he traveled the hundreds of miles in an ecstasy of joy and happiness. "Bhai Gurdas," said the guru when he finally stood before Guru Arjan, "please repeat those lines." Humbled by his arduous experiences, he could not bring himself to recite the lines. Instead, he fell at his guru's feet and said, "If a mother gives poison to her son, who is it that will save him? If the watchman breaks into the house, who can protect it? If a guide leads a traveler astray, who then can set him on the right path? If the fence starts to consume the crop it protects, who can save it? If the guru tests his disciples, who on earth can help them to remain steadfast? It is the Satguru alone who, by his spiritual power and grace, can keep the disciples steadfast and filled with devotion under circumstances such as these."